There are many different ways to always have the right words to respond in any situation. I'm going to give you one of those ways today. Are you ready? Because as a savvy, powerful, professional communicator, that's one of the skills that we should have. We should always have a response, but we should always have a dignified one, right? So there you are, minding your own beeswax. Maybe you're on Zoom, maybe you're at the conference table, maybe you're out with some friends, and somebody says something rude or asks you a rude question. It could be something like,
"Hey, Dan, by the way, how old are you?"
Or it could be like,
"Hey, Dan, what happened with your date last night?"
When they know exactly what happened. What do you say? What do you do? Number one, narrate the scene. I realize, for example, Anna Ruda, that it's difficult to find the words in that situation. So you're searching for words. But the more you search and the more emotional you get, the less likely you are to actually find any words. So make it easy on yourself. And just remember at that moment, narrate the scene. Look around and just say what's going on. That's easy. For example, "So let me see if I get this right. Here we are in a business meeting on a Tuesday afternoon talking about what are going to be the next purchases that our department is going to make. And during that conversation about those technical issues, narrate the scene, you know, just say what's going on." If you do that, that does two different things for you. Number one, it helps you buy some time while you calm down and while your brain is searching for the next step. But during that time also, you're drawing attention to what that person is doing, because we can't teach somebody how inappropriate their behavior is. They have to realize it. They have to recognize how foolish they look when they ask rude questions or say rude things and how it really does not serve them. But we can't tell people that. They have to recognize it for themselves. This helps people recognize it when you are simply narrating the scene and saying what's going on. Number two, ask them to repeat it. So when you get to that point, for example, as I just mentioned, I narrate the scene, so let me get this straight, yada, 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 yada. When you get to step number two, if you really still haven't thought of any, for example, blacklight questions that you could use to respond, clarifying questions that you might use to respond, if you still haven't thought of that, you might just want to ask them to repeat it. So here we are, yada, 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 yada. And tell me again, what was it that you just asked me? Can you repeat that question? Can you say that again? Ask them to repeat it. That'll again buy you some time, and it will force them to repeat that ignorant thing that they just said, that undignified thing that they just said. Remember, remain dignified, Anna Ruda. People notice that much, much more than they will notice, did you have a quick comeback? Especially in this day and age. I mean, there has been a revolution of consciousness, and people are much more concerned with, do you have integrity? Do you have a moral compass? Do you have dignity? Are you someone who deserves respect? And that's something that we decide. So people are much more going to notice that if you maintain your dignity as you respond than if you were to be quick in your response. Okay? That said, number three, look at the crowd, the people who are there as well, and ask them, what is that called? You know, when somebody asks your age at work, when somebody says that type of thing, when somebody makes those types of comments, what is that called? What do we call that? And watch how people who you never thought would come to your aid are going to just out of the woodwork say things like rude, inappropriate, harassment, grounds for firing, things like, you know, they'll say things like that. And you'll all of a sudden realize how much support you have. And they will realize too, again, how inappropriate what they just said was. And you didn't have to say a thing. So far, you have not said a thing other than you've narrated the scene, you asked them to repeat it, you asked other people, what's that called? You haven't really said or done anything, but you're really turning the situation into one where the focus and the spotlight is on that person who said the rude thing or asked the rude thing and off of you. So that'll help your emotions calm down so that maybe by the time you get to step number four, you will remember, ask an open-ended question. An open-ended question just begins with something other than are you or did you or is that. An open-ended question is going to require people to give more than one word. So again, it'll buy you time if you need some time. So an open-ended question would be something like, and why would you think that that would be appropriate to say to me or to ask me? Or why did you think that that was the right thing to say or the right thing to do? Why do you think that I deserve that type of treatment? Why do you think that I deserve to be asked that? Why would you want to put me on the spot like that? What did I do to deserve that? Ask an open-ended question. By the time you get through those first three steps, they will have changed their tune. You know, chances are when they are asked to repeat it, they're going to change their words a little bit. You may want to say something as they do that, like, well, wait a minute, was that what you said? Because that's not what I heard. And if they say, you know, well, I meant blah, blah, blah. Well, I don't know what you meant. You know, I don't have ESP or I don't have a psychic ability to read minds. I just know what you said. And that's not what you said. Do you know what you said? You know, just put people on the spot, turn the tables, and take control of the situation by asking questions and narrating the scene and make other people support what they just said. You don't even need to call them on it. Just shine a light on it. Remember, darkness is simply the absence of light. So when things like that happen, shine light on it. And the darkness tends to scurry away like cockroaches when you flip the switch. So I hope that that helps. And we're going to be teaching a lot of things like that in my upcoming course. So click the link in the description below if you'd like more information on that. And I'm going to be giving away some things as well, like a coupon for $300 off if you wanted to register in the pre-registration stage. That's going to save you over 50% if you use that coupon. So I hope to see you there. And I hope that wherever you are, that you're with somebody you love. And I hope they love you right back, because you deserve that. And they deserve only loving words from you. So there's nothing that you have to say that you can't say in a loving way. If you need any help doing that, that's what I'm here for. So write me, leave a comment. And if you found value in these videos, the best way to support this channel is to hit that subscribe button and the notification bell, as well as leave a comment and like this video or not like it, but tell me why in the comments. And for more information like this, either stop by my course or stop by Dan O'Connor Training and subscribe to our newsletter. You're going to get some great tips there. I think you'll love it. So for everyone here at Dan O'Connor Training, this is Dan O'Connor signing off.